Welcome. These slides explain a theorem in topology. It deals with Fredholm determinants of graphs obtained from simplicial complexes. We call the result the unimodularity theorem. Let G be a finite abstract simplicial complex. This means it's a finite set equipped with a set of non-empty subsets closed under the subset operation. The theorem tells us that two numbers agree. First of all, the Fermi functional, encoding the parity of odd dimensional simplices in G, and then the Fredholm functional, the Fredholm determinant of the adjacency matrix of the connection graph of G. The connection graph is defined as follows. It is a finite simple graph for which the vertices are the faces of the simplicial complex and where two faces are connected if they intersect. Cells are also called faces or simplices. We see here an example of an one-dimensional complex, the star graph. There are 10 zero-dimensional simplices, the vertices, and 9 one-dimensional cells, the edges in G. The one-dimensional faces are all connected to each other in the connection graph. Here is the formal definition in the case when we have a graph equipped with a Whitney complex, the set of subsets of a vertex set V for which all members are connected. Depending on the context or our mood, the elements in V prime are called cliques or simplices or faces or complete subgraphs of G. Two such simplices are connected if they intersect. In this case, when the original graph G is a triangle, we have 7 complete subgraphs and so 7 faces in the simplicial complex. The connection graph is seen to the right. The Fermi characteristic is a cousin of the Euler characteristic, and while the Euler characteristic adds up the signatures of the complete subgraphs, the Fermi characteristic is the product of the signatures. It is 1 if there is an even number of odd-dimensional simplices in the complex. It is -1 if there is an odd number of odd-dimensional simplices present in the complex. For the triangle G, the complete graph with 3 vertices, there are 7 simplices in the Whitney complex. There are 3 vertices, 3 edges, and 1 one-dimensional simplex present. The Fermi characteristic is minus 1. So there is an odd number of odd dimensional simplices present in the triangle. The Euler characteristic is V minus E plus F is 3 minus 3 plus 1, which is 1. Well, the Euler characteristic is 1 for any simplex, or more generally for any contractible graph. The Fermi characteristic is 1 only for the one-point graph. For all other complete graphs, it is -1. When we say Fredholm determinant of a graph, we mean the Fredholm determinant of its adjacency matrix A. This is the determinant of the identity matrix plus A. The Leibniz sum consists of all admissible permutation of vertices in the graph. It is a path integral summing over all one-dimensional oriented subgraphs of G. This includes the empty subgraph. The determinant of A, on the other hand, would only sum of all cyclic oriented subgraphs. The Fredholm determinant of the triangle is 0. You can see this here. That's true for all complete graphs with more than one vertex, because the Fredholm matrix has all entries 1. Obviously singular. This does not contradict the unimodularity theorem, as the latter assures that the Fredholm determinant of the connection graph of a graph is equal to the Fermi characteristic. The consequence is that the complete graphs are not connection graphs of simplicial complexes. Here we see the Leibniz sum contributing to the Fredholm determinant, the case of the triangular graph. There are 3 paths which signature -1 and 3 paths which signature 1, adding to 0. It includes the empty graph which has signature 1. Paths which are transpositions, also a little bit special, as this is the only case where paths can backtrack on the same edge. It's natural to see such transpositions as a path as every of the 2 vertices is visited exactly once. The Fredholm determinant in this case is 0. This graph is not the connection graph of another graph or simplicial complex. The Fredholm characteristic of a graph is defined as the Fredholm determinant of its connection graph. The connection graph, and so the Fredholm characteristic, exists also for simplicial complexes or even discrete CW complexes, combinatorial constructs in which cells are attached to spheres recursively. The connection graph of such a complex is still a graph for which one has an adjacency matrix and so a Fredholm characteristic. Here's the main result. The unimodularity theorem tells that for any complex G, the Fredholm characteristic and the Fermi characteristic agree. It holds not only for abstract simplicial complexes, but also for CW complexes. The consequence of the result is that the Fredholm matrix 1 plus A is unimodular if A is the adjacency matrix of the connection graph. The matrix 1 plus A belongs to GLNC, and the inverse of that matrix is an integer matrix again. That's what one calls a unimodularity. Here is one of the simplest examples. The graph G is the line graph of length 2, consisting of two edges and three vertices. Its Fermi characteristic is 1. There are 11 permutations compatible with the graph. We see all except the identity permutation, which corresponds to the empty path, vacuum. 6 of them have even signature, 5 of them have odd signature. The Fermi characteristic is 1. Here we see the Fredholm path of the connection graph G of the triangle equipped with the usual Whitney complex. The connection graph G prime is a graph with 7 vertices. There are already 601 terms in the Leibniz sum of the Fredholm determinant, and we see 600 here. 301 of them have odd signature, while 300 have even signature. The Fredholm characteristic of the triangle is 300 minus 301, which is minus 1. It agrees with the Fermi characteristic, as there are 3 odd-dimensional simplices in the triangle. The proof of the unimodularity theorem is done inductively by building up the structure as a CW complex, adding more and more cells. In the case when the cell has a sphere as a boundary, then the Fredholm characteristic either stays or changes sign. The constant which determines that multiplication factor is a Poincaré-Hopf index. And we look at this in the next slide. So here's a crucial proposition. It does not assume that H, the unit sphere of the new cell, is a discrete sphere. If H is a subcomplex of J and we attach a new cell X leading to a new connection graph in which X is the new vertex connected to every face which intersects with a face in H, then the Fredholm determinant changes by a factor I of H, which is 1 minus the Euler characteristic of H. We first show that the number of new paths is a valuation, then verify that it takes the value after scaling with psi of g, value 1 on complete graphs, and finally we use that the valuation with this property must be the Euler characteristic. So an induction step is adding cell after cell. When we add a new cell to a complex, we choose a sphere and add a new cell which has this sphere as a boundary. The picture below shows what happens on the connection graph level. We add a new vertex and connect it to all the simplices which had an intersection with the simplices of the sphere. This result has connections with other constructs. The Fredholm determinant is a special value of a Bow and Lanford zeta function. So this zeta function is a special case of a dynamical zeta function as defined by Artin and Maser, and which was further developed by Ruel to become a major tool in dynamical system theory and statistical mechanics. In the case of a graph, the zeta function is associated with the Markov chain defined by the graph. It's a dynamical system then. And it's one of the simplest cases of a zeta function. The unimodularity theorem is an example relating the function value with the topology. Having established that the Fredholm matrix 1 plus A is unimodular, one can look at the green functions, the entries of the inverse matrix of 1 plus A. So these entries are now integers, and it's exciting that we have now we can look at the values of these integers, and it appears that the inverse matrix values are combinatorial invariant. This would mean that a set of values does not change when we do a barycentric refinement or local refinement of the complex, but this has not yet been proven. So here we see a graph and then the connection graph. As a vertices, the complete subgraphs of G. See Fredholm matrix of that connection graph. Proving the theorem, extending the graph G turns out to be complicated because adding a new vertex produces a large change in the matrix. Many columns and rows are added. This is the reason why we deform the graph on the on the simplicial complex level, or even the CW complex level. Here's a particularly interesting case from number theory. It deals with prime graphs, Gn, which have as vertices the set of square free integers larger than 1 and smaller or equal to n. So two numbers are connected if one divides the other. The prime connection graph, seen to the right, Hn, does the connection if the greatest common divisor is bigger than 1. The graph Gn is part of a barycentric refinement of the complete graph on the primes, while Hn is the connection graph of the complete graph of the rational primes. The Fredholm determinant of Hn can be written as a product of the negated Möbius values of its vertices. And this picture takes the point of view that the square-free integers are simplices in a complex. Here we see a few more examples of prime and prime connection graphs. For the prime graphs, the Mertens function is related to the Euler characteristic and so to the cohomology of the geometry. For the prime connection graph, the Fredholm determinant, the value of the zeta function, is related to the product of the Möbius function values. In some sense, we can place the unimodularity theorem as a cousin of the Euler-Poincaré formula relating the Euler characteristic with the cohomologically defined Euler characteristics. In both cases, we have a relation between some combinatorics and some algebra. And the extension proposition, which was crucial for us, then plays the role of the Poincaré-Hopf theorem in topology. So here we see the smallest prime graph for which a second cohomology is non-trivial. It is G105. So what we have now is a two-dimensional sphere present. So this sphere will disappear when n is 2 times 3 times 5 times 7, which is 210, at which point a three-dimensional cell will have been added and destroyed the sphere. On the connection graph level, the Fredholm determinant has a number theoretical interpretation. Its value depends on the number of square-free integers below n, for which the prime factorization is an odd number of prime factors. So this is the end. By the way, the two graphs seen here are both connection graphs. To the left, we see the connection graph of a star graph. To the right, we can admire the connection graph of a barycentric refinement of a wheel graph.